What is going on, you guys? Brandon here, aka Broadus, and today, sadly, I am bringing you guys our last basketball game of the season. Yes, guys, sadly, this is our 10th and final basketball game of the season, and unfortunately, as much as it kills me to stand here in front of the camera and tell you guys that we did not make the playoffs, that's the truth. We didn't make the playoffs. You had to finish with 6 wins, and we only have 4 wins, and this is our last game. So even if we win tonight, we have 5 wins, and you need 6 to make the playoffs. So as much as it kills me, and as much as it hurts for me, you guys know me. I love winning. I love playing in the playoffs, and I just love basketball. So as much as it hurts to stand here and tell you guys that we didn't make the playoffs, that's the truth, sadly. And it kills me. I just feel like I let all you guys down. So first and foremost, I want to apologize. We should have made the playoffs. We should have played better. I do apologize to you guys. I feel like I let you guys down. But anyways, this is our last basketball game of the season. And even though we're not going to be playing in the playoffs, I'm really, really proud of my team. Honestly, I really am. From my brother to all my teammates. So even though we're not making the playoffs, and even though this is our last game, we want to win this game really, really bad. I just got off the phone with all my teammates because this team that we're playing today, they're dirty. They are a dirty team. In case you guys forgot, if you didn't get to watch my video from a couple weeks ago, this team, it got a little bit heated towards the end, and there was some, you know, pushing and shoving, and it got pretty intense. It got so heated to the point where the refs called the game off. The game wasn't even over. There was still time to play, and the refs said, you know what? No, we're done. No more playing, and they called the game off. That's how intense it got, and honestly, the team that we're playing, man, I know a few people on that team. They're my friends. You know, you'll see me when the game starts. I'll go up to them, I'll shake their hand. I love them, especially one dude. He's my boy. I've known him for so long, but they got some other players on their team. Even their own teammates admit that they're dirty. There's two people, and honestly, I'm not even gonna single them out because you guys will see who they are, but they play so dirty, and we don't like that. My teammates, we don't back down. If someone plays dirty, we're gonna step right back up. Me and my teammates, we don't respect that. We don't respect dirty players. Trash talking is okay. I don't care. I like trash talk. You guys know me. I love trash talk. I feel like that's a part of the game. So if someone comes up to me, you know, tell me I suck. Tell me I can't shoot. Tell me I'm a piece of shit. I don't care. But the second you start playing dirty, here's the difference. Trash talking and then playing dirty is all the way up here. That's two different things. I've had way, way too many friends get seriously injured because of a dirty player. I've had a lot of friends who I know who love basketball, and now they got hurt so bad they can never play again because there have been some dirty players who took them out. That's just... You're low if you play dirty. And this team, they got a couple of dirty players. So this game, especially after what happened a couple weeks ago, it's going to be really heated. I'm not gonna lie. It's gonna be physical. It's gonna be intense. And we want to win. We don't want to lose to this team. And we beat them last time. We beat them easily, actually. We beat them by like 15 or 16. So I think that's why they got mad, and that kind of started everything. But we're ready. You know, there was this dude. So you guys saw in the little clip that one dude, number 4, he came up and pushed me, and that started the scuffle. But then there was another dude off camera. I don't even remember which number he was because I did not pay attention to him at all. But he was trying to talk shit to me off camera, like just talking shit. And honestly, I just told him, I said, bro, I didn't even notice you were on the damn team because you didn't do anything the whole game. So he was starting to talk shit. And this team, let's just say it here. I keep talking too much. Let's just say they're dirty. They play in a way where they try to hurt you. And we don't respect that. My teammates, if you try to play dirty with us, we're gonna step right back up and get in your face. So we're ready for this game. We don't wanna lose. I talked to all my teammates on the phone. To my boy that is playing on this team, thank you for admitting that your teammates are dirty, because at least you know it and you're honest. And I love you. That's my boy. That's my guy. I've known him for so long. Anyways, guys, like I said, before you guys kill me in the comment section saying, oh, you can't handle a little trash talk, blah, blah, blah. No, let me repeat myself. I love trash talk. I honestly love when people talk trash to me. I feel like it just makes the game way more fun. I feel like if someone trash talks me, that motivates me to do better. I love trash talk, but playing dirty is so different. Like, playing dirty, though, you could physically hurt someone, and I don't respect that. It's just, it's such a low-life thing to do to try to hurt somebody on the court. My team, we go out there, we shoot the ball, we drive in, and we play basketball. That's what we play. We don't go out there and say, oh, who can we hurt today? Who can we, you know, shove today? We don't do that. We're not a dirty team. But if this team wants to play dirty, just know my teammates, we don't back down. Basketball players should step on the court with the mindset of, oh, I want to play basketball. I want to win this game. You don't step on the court thinking, oh, who can I hurt? That's not true. You're a little bitch if you think like that. And I'm not just saying that to a camera. I'm not saying that behind a computer screen, because everything I'm saying right now, I said it to those dudes' faces. I've had way too many friends, you know, get seriously hurt and be out for a really, really long time because of dirty players. Nobody should be out on the basketball court if you're playing dirty. You should be out on the basketball court to play basketball. So we are 100% ready for this game. I can't wait. My teammates can't wait. And we've been ready for this game ever since that whole thing happened a couple weeks ago. And their teammates, bro, their team lost and they were talking shit. Especially that dude who was off camera. The dude number four who shoved me, he's bad enough. But then they had this dude who, I swear to you, I didn't even know he was on the team because he didn't do anything all game. He had like 0 points. And he started talking mad shit. Like, we're going to see you guys. We'll catch you the last game of the season. Like, trying to act tough. And I'm just like, bro, who are you? Like, I didn't even notice you on the court. Just know, my team, we're not gonna start playing dirty. We're not gonna start anything. We're gonna go out there and play basketball just like we always do. We're just gonna go. You'll see. I want you guys to see. The other team, they go out there on the court with the mindset of, oh, who can we hurt this time? Anyways, we're gonna go out there and play ball. We want this win. We wanna finish the season off with a win, even though we can't make the playoffs. It just, you know me, I hate losing. My teammates hate losing, so we wanna finish it off with a win. It's game time, and I'm gonna see you guys there.
You ready?
Of course.
I could tell you already have your shirt on and everything. Okay, are we beating this team?
Of course, I'm playing extra hard today.
Even though there's no prize, like, oh, if you win, you get to the playoffs, we still want to win because we don't like to lose. Especially against a dirty team, we don't like to lose against a team like that. You look so handsome.
Do I?
Yeah, you look handsome today. Okay, guys, I repeat. Me, Brian, you know, my teammates, we are not going to play dirty. We are not going to start playing dirty. However, if that team wants to come out and play dirty, we're grown men. My whole teammates, we don't mess around like that.
I bet they will.
Yeah, I bet they will. Exactly, Brian. They will 100% because of last game. Remember what happened off camera, guys? There was a huge thing that happened off camera where, like I said, the dude who I didn't even know was playing, he just started getting in my face. And I just said, bro, get the fuck out of my face. I don't know who you are, blah, blah, blah. So I bet you anything, they're going to start the dirty play. But just know that me and my teammates, we're not going to start it. We don't go out there with the intention of, oh, let's fight. Let's play dirty. We're not about that. We just go out and play basketball. However, I will say this, if that other team starts playing dirty, then my teammates don't mess around, so we will fight right back. So this game will probably be physical.
But honestly, I love physical games. I love playing in games that are physical, intense, and I love playing against people who talk a lot of shit. I feel like if a game isn't physical, it's really boring. And I've had this game circled on my calendar ever since that whole scuffle happened a couple weeks ago, so I'm ready.
Man, and not only do I want to win for myself and for my team, but I want to win this game for you guys. So I'm going to try my ass off. I'm going to try my butt off, and I'm going to try my best to win this game for you guys, the Brawad Squad, for everybody watching this video, because I feel like since we missed the playoffs, the least we could do, we owe you guys a win tonight.
Because Brian dropped it, so now I won't focus. We have to literally Brandon couldn't play basketball at the gym today, so all his energy is literally gonna be here. You guys, maybe I'll be good at commentating. Oh. Do you hear that? They're literally like six, I think. Illuminati. That's not right. I want to speak to the teachers. I didn't even know what the Illuminati meant until I was like literally like maybe last year. I don't remember how old. By the way, you guys, Brandon's birthday is coming up, just so you guys all know, June 23rd. Mark your calendars. Go, go, go. To the paint. Oh. Well, let me in. Mi pelo se me está cayendo. I don't know why that's so funny. Oh no! Come on, Rob! Oh. Hey guys, I can slowly but surely tell Brandon's getting angry. It's 9-13 with 11 minutes left. 13 to 17. There's 7 minutes left. Go.
Number 22 talks a bunch of shit for someone who played 1 minute and then just came out. He's been talking.
Oh, no. Going to graduate. Woo! It's for sure gonna end up in a fight. You know when you just know your man's about to fight? It's like you have an intuition.
Pulled his hammy because he's doing extracurricular activities at night. So he can't do that move with his lady no more.
Okay, guys, what happened right here is just ridiculous. This just made me realize what a poor sport that dude is. So as you see, he kind of sprains his ankle. And he got hurt. Mind you, this is the dude that talks a bunch of shit. But I actually went up to him because I saw that he was in pain. And I asked him if he's okay. And he ignored me. And then I stuck my hand out like to shake his hand like, yo, are you good? And he turned down my handshake. Bro, this is the dude that was talking the most shit. This is the dude that I almost got in a fight with. This is the dude that bumped me last game. And when he got hurt, I still felt bad enough to the point where I went up to him to see if he was okay. And I stuck my hand out and he completely ignored me and he turned down my handshake. Like, I'm an opponent. You guys saw when my teammate Alvin got injured, he didn't go up to him. He didn't ask him if he was okay. But me, I'm a different person. I felt bad. I went up to him. I tried to see if he was okay. And he completely ignored me. If that's not the biggest case of being a poor sport, then I don't know what is, but that's just ridiculous. The fact that he's that old and that immature is crazy.
Okay, guys. Okay, so we're starting the second, 24 to 23. So we're up.
You're about to see right now and for the rest of the game, I'm actually in shock. Like, I did not know people this immature existed. I was just walking down the court, you know, I'm just playing basketball. I'm not even talking. I'm just playing basketball. And I hear someone from the bench say, you fucking suck. You suck. All this, like, just talking shit. And so I look over to the bench and it's the dude who I tried to help up when he got injured. And he's laughing and talking shit, saying, you fucking suck, stop playing basketball, you know, all the shit. And I looked at him like, bro, you're on the fucking bench, bro. Why are you talking? And it's just so immature because this is the same guy that I tried to help up. This is the same guy who got hurt and I stuck my hand out to help him up. And he turned me down and he walks over to the bench and he starts talking shit. It's just, it's crazy because my mouth was shut all game. I was just playing basketball. I was doing my thing. And it's also funny that he was saying I suck when I was the leading scorer on both teams. I had already scored like 15 points at this point. And this actually is going to be an ongoing issue for the rest of the game. You're going to see me and him going back and forth the whole entire game because he would not shut up. I was just surprised because I swear to you, I didn't say a word all game. This dude is like 30 years old and he's screaming off the bench after I tried to help him up when he got injured. That's just, I don't know, it's ridiculous, but you guys know me, I don't back down, so I was talking back to him the whole entire game, and the funniest thing was, every single time I got close to him, He didn't say a single word. He would only shout it when I was all the way across the court.
It's 29 to
30, 17
minutes left.
Watch when they close up and they watch after the, watch when they go to-
Should I pour my coffee on this ref? I need to confirm what he said before I act out. Left. Second quarter. Guys, we're down 1 point. I wonder how many people watch this video so that they could see themselves in it. It's 34 to 39, 8 minutes left. I know Brayden's getting pissed. I see that guy literally talking shit to him, and he's not even guarding him, so I'm confused. But I see his mouth moving a lot. So apparently Gilbert and the guy in the red shorts got ejected. I'm confused as to why, but I know why the red one got ejected. I don't know why Gilbert got ejected. So. It's 34 to 41 with 6 minutes left.
Just listen, you could hear his voice. He wasn't even cheering on his team. He was just shit talking us the whole game. I repeat, he was not cheering on his team. He wasn't even concerned about his team winning. He was more concerned with what I was doing. His eyes were glued on me the whole game, just talking shit. Bro, off the bench. He wasn't even in the game. He was off the bench. The same dude that I tried to help up.
I hate his, wow.
Come on, defense!
Woo! 37 to 46, 3 minutes left.
So the refs didn't call this a double dribble. Are you kidding me? I'm in shock. I'm disgusted by this call. The man lost the ball on his own and then kept on dribbling it. That is a double dribble, and the refs did not call it. Even his own teammates thought it was a double dribble. Even his own team started walking the other way. But the refs said, nope, stay here, white ball.
Talking shit from the sidelines.
Bitch.
They're quiet now, huh? Look.
Okay, guys, so we're going to overtime thanks to my brother's clutch shot. But the funniest thing was that everyone who was talking shit off the bench, when there was like 1 or 2 minutes left, they kept pointing at the scoreboard and telling me, hey, look at the score, we won. Look at the score, the game's over, we won. And now we're sending it to overtime. So I was dying laughing. I was so hyped when Brian hit that shot. I went straight to their bench and got in their faces. They were so quiet. That shut them up so fast. They were so quiet when I went over to their bench. It was funny.
Looks like the crowd finally woke up, huh? You thought your job was over, huh?
Hell yeah, my black ass.
No.
I've been talking all game. He's been talking.
Buck number 22.
Boo! Yeah! Let's go!
They really didn't give me an and one on that. They said it was a foul on the floor. They said I wasn't going up with the shot. I got robbed of an and one. Just watch this. They really said this was not an and one. So they gave me 2 free throws. That is, wow. How was this not an and one? That's ridiculous.
To 50. Woo! All right, it's 50 to 50 with 38 seconds left.
They were sitting on the bench and talking shit. It was funny.
What did he say to you from the sideline?
He was talking all game, but he wouldn't get on the court.
How many? points.
Hey, I love this ref. This is my guy.
Hey, hell of a game to my guy. That shit was close, bro.
That was, man. Overtime game? Overtime game.
We won in double overtime. My shot felt so good.
Had a nice look. They almost went in. Almost had a heart attack.
Close, bro. Now, all of them. Who hit the game winner? You hit the game winner? Good game, bro. All you guys. Good shit, bro. Congrats. We'll see you guys next season. All right, bro.
Yo, you know what I find really funny? I find this hilarious, actually. The two shit talkers that were talking shit and the dirty players, the two of them, where were they after the game? They were nowhere to be found. The second the game ended, they were gone. They didn't say a word to my face. They didn't come up to me. They were just gone. It's like they disappeared. They vanished like a magic trick. But the rest of the team, they were all there. And I congratulated them and I high-fived them. But the two people that were talking shit all game, the second the game ended, I'm not going to say they were scared. I don't know if they were scared or not, but they were gone like within a second. They were out of that place. So I don't know. That's just, you know, you're going to be talking shit all game. And then the second you don't have the refs to protect you, you're going to leave. That's not really a good look. It makes you look like a pussy. But I don't know. Who knows? The rest of their team were there. So you can't say their whole team left because their whole entire team was there except for those two. I just find that really, really funny, honestly. Even Brian was saying, we find that really funny that you're going to be talking a bunch of shit when there's two refs on the court and a bunch of people. But the second the game's over and there are no refs and no one to protect you, then you're gone. I don't know. Me and Brian were talking about that last night. It's funny. Oh my gosh. That shot felt so good. It was so close. Oh, Brandon. I hate you. I hate myself so much. I'm not going to be able to sleep knowing that I missed that shot. We were down by three at the buzzer. I got a good look. It felt good and I missed the shot. Oh my gosh. I hate. Oh, damn. Wow. I am so upset with myself. I'm incredibly upset with myself. I hate Brandon. You suck. Brandon, you suck at basketball. Hold on, guys. Sorry, I can't really vlog right now.
Hey, Hammy. Did you know that I fucking suck at basketball? Did you know that, Hammy? Did you know Brandon Awadis, aka Brawadis, sucks at basketball?
Oh, I'm so angry with myself. I'm so upset with myself right now. We should have.
Okay, guys. Brandon here, aka Brawadis. I'm here to close this video out. Hey, what can I say? We lost. They played the better game. They hit a really, really clutch shot at the end. But about those two people that were talking shit all game, I just find it hilarious that he decided to talk all that shit. After when he got hurt, I went up to him and I simply said, yo, bro, are you okay? He ignored me. So in my head, I'm like, maybe he just didn't hear me because it's loud in there. So I stuck my hand out to help him up. And he turned me down like he went like this. And then he's going to talk a bunch of shit. And this dude is older than me. He should be more mature. Honestly, that whole sequence made me realize some people in this world are so like small-minded. Some people are so immature. And hey, I'm gonna just keep doing me. I'm a good sport. You know, if I see somebody get hurt, I'm gonna try to help them up, no matter if they talk shit to me or no matter if he shoved me a couple weeks ago. I don't care. I don't like when people get hurt. So when he got hurt, I felt bad and he decided to be talking shit the rest of the game. So like I said, I respect shit talking. I like shit talking, but I'm talking about when you're on the court. I don't respect someone who sits on the bench all game and is talking shit. If you're not on the court, you shouldn't be talking. That's just my mindset. And then the other dude, number 22, bro, he didn't score the whole entire game. And he started the shit talking. He started the dirty playing. When we started, like I said, my team, we weren't going to start the dirty playing. We were just going to play basketball. So minutes and minutes in, everybody was just playing basketball. Everybody was cool. And then he comes in, oh, you fucking suck. You fucking suck. I'm like, bro, can you make a basket before you talk? Because it looks embarrassing if you're talking shit without even scoring the ball. So anyways, they won. They beat us. I can't wait for next season. I think I had 24 points, and it was a crazy game. Shout out to Brian. I wish he hit that half-court shot. If Brian hit that half-court shot, oh my goodness, that place would have erupted. It would have went crazy. So anyways, shout out to my teammates. Although we missed the playoffs, I had a really, really fun time playing this season. We're keeping the band together. We're keeping this team together, and we're coming back stronger. We had Chris missing for 8 games. We only played 10, and Chris was out for 8. You guys know Chris, he's a good player. So to be missing him for 8 games, that hurt us a lot. And I'm ready. I hope we play them the first game of the season because I am ready. I'm so ready to play them again. Hey, I was just doing me. My mom raised me to be a better person. My mom raised me that when I see someone down and hurt, even though they're talking shit to me, to go help them up. But I guess the way he was raised,
I don't know. He wasn't raised too well because he turned down my offer to help him up. Honestly, if we're being honest, I was even gonna help him up to the bench. I was gonna walk him all the way to the bench. But then when he turned down my handshake, I was like, all right, bro, you go do you. And I was just surprised that he started talking shit because I kid you not, I was just playing basketball. I did not have one word to say to him. But then, you guys know me, if he's gonna start talking shit, I'm gonna talk shit right back. So yeah, and I tried to go up to him after the game so I could ask him, yo, what's your problem? You know, I wanted to go up to him face to face. And he was gone. Both of them were gone. But the whole rest of the team were there. So I just find that weird because if the whole team left, then that makes sense. You know, they're all gone. But the fact that those were the only two that left, I was looking for him after the game. I just wanted to say, yo, what's up? Like, I tried to help you up. You turned it down. And then you were talking all game. What's up? Like, you got something against me or what? And then the funniest thing ever, one of his boys, I won't rat them out, but one of his teammates told me the truth. And it finally... it hit me like, this guy, are you kidding me, bro? After what one of his teammates told me, I'm just in shock. Like, I'm embarrassed. I don't know. So they told me that he's always wanted a BMW i8, and he saw that I drove a BMW i8, and he's jealous, and that's why he plays dirty and tries to hurt me. What, bro, are you kidding me? I know you're watching this video and you ran away after the game, so I'm speaking to you right now. Are you kidding me? You are older than me. You are almost 30 years old. I'm only 21. And instead of, you know, like, what? You, what? Guys, I'm sorry. I'm really, really confused right now. If you younger people don't understand this confusion, I apologize. But so he's out there trying to hurt me and talking shit to me because I drive the car that he isn't able to drive. Are you kidding me? That's just crazy. I've never, like, yo. And I don't flex my car. I don't pull up into the parking lot bumping my music. You guys know me. I always stay humble. So it's like, what? I just, if I saw someone driving my dream car and, you know, they were younger than me, I would go to them and say, yo, good shit, bro. Mad props to you. That's dope. And I don't know. That's just weird. I still don't fully believe it. But at the same time, why would his teammate lie to me? I don't want to let myself believe that because I don't want to believe there's people that jealous on earth. And I, like I said, I stay humble with it. I never flex my car. I never pull up into the parking lot bumping music with the windows down. I don't do that. So I don't understand where that came from. But we'll see you next season. I know you're watching this. And it's funny how you ran away after the game. Anyways, guys. Oh, and to the other dude that was talking shit, bro. At least the other guy, number four, who talks shit, the one that got hurt, he's actually good. You, bro. Why? Why are you talking shit? You didn't even score 1 point. And the fact that you left after the game, it just, I don't know. I wanted to talk to you guys face to face. I guess we gotta wait till next season because I want that face to face talk. And I know you guys are watching this video, so you know I want that face to face talk. So I'd appreciate it if you didn't run away the second the game ended. Oh, and if anybody comments, you know, Brandon, why are you acting tough behind the camera? Why don't you say it to their face? Nope, I don't want to hear that because every single thing that I'm saying in this outro and every single thing that I'm saying in this video, I said directly to their face and they were still out of there after the game. Every single thing that I've said in this outro, I said it to their face and they had nothing to say. So I don't want to hear people say, oh, you're only saying this on camera or you're only speaking to a camera, but you won't say it to their face because I said it to their face all game. They just had nothing to say. It was funny. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I apologize we didn't make the playoffs. Next season, I promise we'll come back stronger. Brawad Squad, I love you guys all, and we don't like dirty players.